Hello, everyone. Welcome to Morning English. This is Colin.
Hi, guys. 欢迎大家收听早安英文 This is Blair.
Why are you so tired? It's the first day of the week.
Well, I didn't get enough sleep last night. 昨天晚上认真学习去了。
You stayed up late to study? You are a geek.
不是什么正经学习啦，就是女孩子嘛，你知道的，就喜欢看一些化妆教程之类的。我昨天晚上就看到很晚。
Oh, makeup tutorials. Well, that's understandable. I'll be judging you if you are actually studying.
我相信很多女生都跟我一样啊，喜欢看化妆教程，活到老学到老嘛。那这个化妆教程我们来学习一下，叫做 makeup tutorial。Makeup 我们很熟悉，就表示化妆。那这个教程教学，我们就可以用 tutorial 来表示。
Yeah, tutorial is used as a noun here, and it can be a short book, a computer program, or a video that gives information on a particular subject or explains how something is done.
对，那 Colin 老师，你看过这些 makeup tutorials 吗？
Well, the answer would be the same as me asking you if you've watched videos about assembling car parts.
No, and have absolutely no idea what is going on.
That is exactly right.
想你也不会看啊。不过说到这个美妆教学，最近国内外呢都掀起了一股儿童美妆博主的热潮，你有关注过吗？
Children makeup bloggers?
Yeah.
How old are the children we're talking about?
就五六七八岁吧，反正最小的我看到是才五岁。
Okay, well, I don't think this is something good, so...How about we talk about it in today's podcast?
Okay, 那今天就跟大家一起来聊一聊最近很火的儿童美妆博主吧。
Hello, welcome to Morning English. 早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新。如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容，我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语。如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外，点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频啦。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
Well, I understand that for little girls or sometimes little boys, they may have had a pretend makeup set or smeared their lips with their mother's lipstick while she wasn't watching.
没错啊，就小女孩一般都爱美，对不对？小时候呢，肯定都偷看过妈妈化妆。或者拿妈妈的口红啊，给自己的脸上画一个大花脸，对不对？那这里我们来学习一个词啊 ，smear。
Well, smear here means to spread an oily or soft substance over a surface in a rough or careless way.
对，那 smear 我们这里就可以把它翻译为乱涂乱画。小时候大家肯定都干过这个事儿啊，拿着妈妈的口红啊，乱涂乱画的。
But how can they teach people how to put on makeup?
就现在网络这么发达呀，小孩子接触的早，而且有一些父母就觉得无所谓了，孩子想要啥就给啥。
Okay, so thanks, or no thanks, to social media and overindulgent parents, five-year-olds these days could be more familiar with highlighting than high fives.
没错，由于社交媒体 social media 的普及啊，还有一些家长的溺爱，导致小孩子呢就过早的接触了这些原本不属于他们的东西。那这里我们学习到了一个新词，就是我们说家长的过分放纵、过分溺爱，我们就可以说 overindulgent.
Yes, if you are indulgent, you treat a person with special kindness, often in a way that is really not good for them.
对，溺爱肯定是不对的，对不对？有些家长啊，就孩子想要啥就给啥，完全不拒绝。
It could even be the parents who get their children started on makeup in the first place.
Why?I mean, how?
Well, they may think it's adorable to see their little ones playing with lipstick and let them continue to explore.
Or it could be makeup-obsessed mothers who take playing doll up a little overboard by overindulging their daughter's interest in makeup.
Yeah, that's right.
确实啊，就归根结底呢，大部分都还是家长的原因。有些家长可能觉得孩子化妆是一件很可爱的事情。我觉得啊，可爱归可爱，但是像现在变成了一个博取眼球的方式，这个性质就完全不一样了。
Yeah, more importantly, there are actually dermatology consequences to consider.
What is dermatology?
Dermatology is a branch of medicine dealing with the skin, its structure, functions, and diseases.
啊，那这个 dermatology 我们就可以翻译为皮肤医学，就反正跟皮肤有关吧。小孩子化妆最直接的影响就是皮肤了。
Yeah, as we know, a child's skin is thinner and has a decreased barrier function as compared to adults.
对，我觉得这个都能理解啊。我们都说小孩子的皮肤更薄，对不对？更嫩。所以抵御外界刺激的这个能力就没有这么好。哎，柯林老师，这个 barrier function 是什么意思啊？
Well, the skin's barrier function refers to its ability to keep moisture in and damaging elements out.
哦，我知道了。那这个 barrier function 我们就可以翻译为肌肤的屏障功能。
Yeah, so children's skin is less able to defend itself against irritants.
对，我们说小孩子皮肤娇嫩嘛，所以抵御外界刺激的这个能力啊就更差。这个 irritant 就表示刺激物。
Yes, irritant is used as a noun here. An irritant is a substance that causes a part of your body to itch or become sore.
And with prolonged use, this can adversely affect the barrier and structure of the skin, causing it to be more sensitive to other things like water, soap, sweat, and heat.
Yes, and consider this too.If you have difficulty getting your child to brush her teeth or shower, how do you ensure she'll properly remove her makeup?
对，化妆还不是最大的问题啊。我们知道不卸妆或者说卸妆不干净，对于皮肤的伤害呢甚至更大。那小孩子哪里有卸妆的意识嘛？所以对他们来说，这也是一个非常大的问题。
I think the whole thing is stupid. Kids with makeup. How can she believe in her natural beauty if she's...A make-up even as a child.
我赞同啊，小孩子的皮肤，小孩子漂亮的脸蛋是多少人羡慕都羡慕不来的。而且几岁的小朋友三观都还没有建立，他们也根本就不知道自己本身的样子就是最美的。这些都是需要家长去引导的。
Yeah, think about this. A 10-year-old girl is walking on the street, fully made up, and some boys come up and ask for her number because they think she's 25.How weird would that be?
Super weird. Makeup only makes you look older. I mean, for kids.
Yeah, yeah. It's not okay to sexualize a kid.
太早的把孩子性别化、性感化是不对的。我们这里学习到一个词啊 ,sexualize.
Sexualize means to make somebody or something seem sexually attractive.
对,我们可以把这个词翻译为性别化或者性感化。孩子应该是天真无邪的。过早的让孩子接触到成人的世界只会破坏这份美好。
I mean, it's okay to do makeup on your daughter one time and use the right and safe products like school performances or face painting parties, but it's not okay if she wears it every day.
对，只要互联网存在呢，孩子们对于其中光鲜亮丽的内容的向往就不会消失，而由此产生的儿童美妆产业链也只会扩大。所以要真正做到保护未成年人，我们任重而道远。
Hello, welcome to Morning English. 早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新。如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容，我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语。如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外，点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频啦。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
OK, 那我们今天的节目呢，就到这里了。
So thanks for joining us, everyone. This is Colin.
And this is Blair. See you next time.
Bye! Bye.